I've mentioned this before. We are in a marathon relay race. We're not in a sprint. Let's just reflect very quickly on the last 3 years, just the last 3 years. Okay, let me, if I may, remind your audience just how much we collectively, all of us, your audience included, have been able to accomplish in just 3 years. First of all, you have the acknowledgement that the UFO program called ATIP existed and was real. You also have the acknowledgement that those three videos were absolutely real and they were taken from DoD weapon systems. You also have the acknowledgement that we have no idea what they are, that they are truly unidentified aerial phenomena. You have the establishment of a UAP task force, not unidentified aerial balloons or drones, but unidentified aerial phenomena. You have classified briefings being provided to Congress. Then you, on top of that, you have briefings being provided to the President of the United States and the President admitting that he received briefings on this topic. Then on top of that, you have a 180-day report, which I suspect we're going to talk about a little bit today, and what that means. And on top of that, you have a signed document by the DepSecDef that came out and said, hey, look, Kathy Hicks, saying we need to develop a strategy, a long-term strategy, not just something to answer this 180-day report, but long-term going into the future, we need to provide resources, assets, and talent behind it. Then you have recently in the new latest legislation language saying that not only do we now want a 180-day report, but we want a report every 90 days. And oh, by the way, that includes anything that you haven't reported to us before. So get ready because there's a lot of information coming out. And then, oh, on top of that, you have an IG evaluation and an IG investigation on the handling of this topic within the Department of Defense and the intelligence community. So that has all happened in the last 3 years. In the last 3 years, you have countries like Japan coming out and establishing a bilateral relationship with the United States government for the sole purpose of sharing UAP-related information. That ain't a bad track record, folks. And you all made that happen. So yeah, I get it. We're itchy for the we're waiting for that next dopamine hit. But let's not lose sight of how far we really have come and where we need to go. The last thing we want to do is prematurely do something that is not quite ready for prime time, and it winds up working counter to what we're trying to do. So the good news is there's a lot happening. There's going to be a lot more happening. I said we're firmly into third gear right now, and we are. There's some things in the next 2 and 3 months that I'm personally involved with, and my colleagues like Chris Mellon, that I think, if the public were to find out, they'd be pretty surprised, and extremely excited. We're moving right along.